And here it is on page 25. It talks about the spiritual solution. If you have your big book there, and this is directly related to the food. It says, when we there approach, there is a solution. Again, I always say, why is it called there's a solution? Okay, there's a reason it's called there's a solution. Because we got it right here in front of us. Okay, well, I'll start from the beginning. Almost none of us like the self-searching leveling of our pride, the confession of shortcomings with the process requires for successful consummation. But anyway, it goes on to say here, when therefore, I'm skipping a few sentences ahead, when therefore we approach by those in whom the problem had been solved. It's telling you here the problem had been solved. I have a solution now. I was always in the problem with my food addiction, with people in all those situations. I was definitely in the problem. But now I have a solution to those problems right now. So we have the solution here. There was nothing left for us to do, and it's telling us what it is here, but to pick up the simple kit of spiritual tools laid at our feet. Okay, the 12 steps, what are they talking about here? The 12 steps, which is, again, these 12 steps are everything, all the cultures, the Eastern, Western, ancient Greek philosophies, you name it, it's in here. When I read this first part of this book, and I tell you, when somebody talks about, and I read religious books, they talk about, I don't know, confession, prayer, meditation, you know, all of these things. Step 3 talks about giving our will and our lives over to a higher power. When you go to any kind of religious place, they talk about, the prayers are all about, you know, that higher consciousness, the God within. Again, we were creating God's image. It's all the same thing. It's really, really true. Look, even if you don't want to believe this higher power business, whatever it is, this world was made perfect in perfection. Look at the way the flowers are, life, the way the earth, and everything has definite order. Believe me, your whole body physically, you know, the way the neurons flow and the chemicals and all of this, you were made to be happy. It's just that God also gave us this gift of the intellect, but it's called self-will one rider. We made a decision to use our intellect to figure these things out. And that's why it says this comprehension is beyond all understanding. If you're coming in here trying to figure this out, if you don't do these steps through your heart, I don't know how many people say, you know, I say, well, did you want to do the steps? They'll call me up. They have these issues and problems. They'll say to me, Bob, I've done the steps 10 times. I went through them. I did pages and pages of inventory. You know what? When you do these steps, when you do step one, you know, the step one gives us the answer to all our problems. Step one alone. I mean, we got 12 steps here. If I'm telling you step one, when you admitted you were powerless, and you put for alcohol, food, anything else in your life, what more do you need to know? Now, during the day, I could feel like, but I know it's not true. If I feel resentful, angry, or upset, I just know these things aren't true. In other words, I have that understanding now that it's false. And the way I know it's false is because that thinking never got me anywhere. You know, the past could be an illusion. I don't even know. And I know that if 10 people or all the people who are at this meeting here now all have different opinions about what's going on, you know? That's the way my life is. I saw it through my stinking thinking. You know, just like with the food, the corporations are the ones who put in my brain that I had to think a certain way towards the food, that it was a solution. You ever watch the commercials? You feel like, you know, they make you feel, and it's like drug. It's like shooting up drugs. It's the same thing. Now, we couldn't avoid it before, like a hot flame on a stove. We knew it was bad because it says on page 24, this is what the problem was, and then And on page 24, the problem, we talked about the solution, but I just want to go back on page 24 in italics. The fact is that most alcoholic or food addicts, for reasons yet obscured, have lost the power of choice and drink. We lost that power. Our thinking was all about the food and the alcohol, and drugs was our answer, or people, money, success. Our so-called willpower became practically non-existent. We came in here, we were spiritually bankrupt. We have a solution. We have a way out. We can get out of this and this natural high, just, you know, this feeling is going to surpass it. Abstinence tastes better than food, I said. It's just that we have, when we get that spiritual bread and that grace and that love and that, you know, and things, and we feel it, you know, just the soul, that inner source, it was always there. We bury it. Every day we bury it with the defects of character, pride, envy, lust, all of these things. You know, I talked about the senses. We have what's called the sixth sense, getting out of these five senses. They're there for a purpose. Even our intellect is there for a purpose. You know, we should be in fear, right? It's all self-centered fear if somebody has a gun to our head. But we misuse it. How crazy are we if somebody looks at us the wrong way? I mean, all of these things are, somebody says something to us. That's where we're more insane. And we go and say, that person is toxic, they're bad. No, we're the insane ones, because they can only do if we allow it to happen in our head. If we have this, you know, this guy I knew from India, he told me this story where I worked. He said, look, when the elephant walks down the street and the dogs bark, the elephant doesn't care. When we have this God consciousness, this God esteem, and I was talking about the other day about self-esteem. What's self-esteem? Wanting to be better than other people? That's to do with the self. The word self is in there. No, we got God esteem. We have higher consciousness. We go through the day. It's all about this higher consciousness. It's not about all these little plans and designs. Hey, we came from dust. We're going to dust. That's all I got to say about that. So it just says here, the problem is we can't remember on that italics on page 24, even what happened a day or week ago. But now we have a better way, a better solution.